of the church. I think this session is undoing, so this is anchored on pastoral management based on your six units design. I was looking for an exam, that's what I wanted to take today. No, where is Dr. Lee? Okay, Dr. Lee is the So anyway, I was looking at the requirements. I said, wow, it's six units. I thought all the while, it's just an invitation on my end to really facilitate. I thought all catechists, so I didn't expect that I would see a lot of fathers and sisters, and fathers, the reverend. But anyway, I didn't expect that it will be at the level of the administrators, or in business we call it the managers, administrators. On your end, I think that's the term that we use rather than managers. No, we're not used to it, but it's not, doesn't sound like a church, but in reality, that's it. But anyway, what I'm saying is, I'm hoping that given the one-day session that we have, I'll be able really to give some tips. Now, I think we can take a look at it. I have been really active with the church ever since. So it takes 36 years. Part of what I do is really helping the parishes do all of this planning, workshop, visioning. I belong to the parish of Our Lady of the Abandoned in Mandaluyong, but outside of the mental hospital. This is our former parish priest, because our parish is being administered by the Mission Society of the Philippines. We just had a new church. In fact, I wanted to show you our church. Now it's newly constructed. Bishop Sok Mishona was recently installed as the Bishop of Puerto Princesa. That's for Grabe 22. We're so happy that our parish priest was given a higher assignment. But of course, on our end, siyempre, to lose a parish priest that we love. But if we don't love, okay lang. So anyway, so... Ma, ano po ba ito? Parish management? They can re-history po ba ito? I was asking Melanie, I think we have someone who is not... Right? There is someone who is not a Filipino. Right? Melanie, where are you? Anyway, she told me you love Filipinos. And then I asked her, in fact, am I going to use Filipino? So I thought all the white catechists, no? Yung level na, and then because we know who are these people. So in this case, but when I saw your profile, diocese of, ano ba ito? Sabi ko, marunong ba tong Filipino? Bisaya, git, no? But anyway, so I said, okay. So basically, maybe instead of really using Filipino, basically English, Taglish, whatever, but as long as we can understand each other, yes. Anyways, enjoy the day. Yes. Okay. Yes. People management, the way, sabi ko, mga parish, mga madre, kaya alam na nila ito, pinag-usta nga, reflection, retreat, no, marang gano'n. Like, so your program, lahat, may misa, no, every day, parang ganyan. But I think our context for today is as administrators of the ministry, as far as catechesis or the catechetical ministry is concerned, I just want to find out as a profile, so when I look at you, I'll be able to discuss more practical terms, no, on how we manage. We have been managing people at the parish level. I just want to find out among you who are really the directors already of the catechetical ministry. I mean, you are actually, because I saw future the directors of the, yung actual na po kayo. Yeah. So, actual directors. How many of you, diocese po ba na level? Yes. Okay. How many of you are assistant, meaning assisting the director of the ministry, but still an administrator?
Coordinator.
Oo. Very particular pa sila. Coordinator o sige na. Assistant. Parang job description. Coordinator. Okay, coordinator. Anybody here who is a catechist and potential coordinator? O, director. O, iba pa yun. O, director. Pagkaiba yung title, parang hindi yung director. Mas mababa po ba yung director sa coordinator? Mamaya natin pag-usapan yung structure. No? O, director. Kung hindi natawag director. PA.
Teacher.
Teacher.
teacher. Ayun, may teacher. Yan. Yan. Sino po dito ang walang minamanage na tao? Meaning, you don't have someone you don't have someone to supervise. But basically, you do. Everybody, sino ang walang supervise? Seminarias. Okay. Seminarias, meaning you don't manage. Maybe let me just use manage ng people. One or two, even volunteers. Wala sa talagang kayo lang. Okay. But predominantly, everybody at some point has managed, even at least one, importante yun, eh, no? You have one or, di ba? Sabi ni Cristo, at least or more. Okay. Basta po, 30, tapos na tayo. Ano? Walang break sa umaga.
Meron!
Wala na po tayong madi-discuss pagka ganun. Can we eat here?
Yes.
Is it all right with you? Is it working in the morning? Okay, yan. Basta mag-re-recite kayo. May grade ba to? Okay, so yun, I just want to... How many of you have been in the ministry profile again less than 5 years? Meaning in the catechetical means. Less than a year. Who has been with the ministry between 6 and 10 years? More than 10 years in the ministry. How many of you are parish priests?
Parish priest.
How many of you are doing archdiocesan or vicariate work other than being a church administrator? Like
diocesan.
I mean, diocesan. Yeah. Okay, diocesan function. Meaning, other than the catechetical ministry. Okay. I want to discuss people management actually, not only in the context of catechetical ministry. Because when you talk about people management, and that's why I'm asking as a parish priest, because basically you manage people, no? In the context of catechetical ministry, we're talking about, of course, other than the people that they are, the people that we catechize, I saw the children, the youth, and the adult in that case. Because this is also part of what we do. We also, in the context of our language, we also manage them, although the idea is to evangelize, right? That's the goal, to contribute to the mission of the church as a whole, in that case. But not on the content of what we do, but really part of what is our cross, using Arthur, is really managing people, right? Because there are many concerns that we have in doing our particular ministry that becomes a challenge on our end. You know, usually it's really the human side of it. And that's stressful, right? Okay, so that's the context wherein I want to discuss first human resource management. Since this is a certificate course, don't worry, you will have your handout. We don't need to make... So, ano lang tayo, interactive. You don't need to... Wala lang po tayong exam, no? So, multiple choice lang at the end. Multiple choice. Naka-true all po. Yun lang ang exam natin at the end. Okay. So, I promise that all the things that you will see will be given to you, but my style is I don't give the handout at the beginning. You will have it at the end. Oh, no pressure. Pag sumagot kayo, may handout kayo. So anyway, since this is a certificate course rather than plainly a training program, just to update, I want to be more scholarly about people management so that you have a handle, no? As far as it is concerned, if you are a teacher or maybe in the future you will teach in the seminary, there is a subject on pastoral management. I think what is important is to anchor our understanding of people management in terms of theoretical foundation, because when you started the program, you have certain social doctrines of the church, no? Wherein you anchor the teaching of the catechism in that case. So similar to this, and there are many, but I just want to focus on a few of the foundations. No? So what are the theoretical foundations? So obviously, for example, this is something that's new to you, you have encountered. So basically, when you talk of managing people, there is that model of social systems. No? So you talk about people interaction, there is no such thing as man is an island, no? In that case, human. So when you talk of managing people, you're really talking of people interaction, people interacting with one another. That is the social system. You belong that, basically, if it's a workplace, you're talking of your organization as your unit of your what functioning, right? So in the context of a family, you're talking of the family as the unit of society, if it's the context of the family. Now, if you talk of that, since this is the year of the parish, so your parish is your unit, right? So that is my unit. My parish is my unit. So when we have BECs, so I just want to tell you that. So in that case, it's the BEC that is the life of the parish, right? So the aggregation and the functioning of the BECs, but this is something that you manage. How do you do the catechism? You go through these BECs depending on the style. I don't know what, but at least our parish is one of the models as far as the BEC is concerned. And we are active as far as I do the education. I'm the coordinator of the education ministry. I'm the president of the lecture commentator. So I know what it is to go to do the groundwork. No? So we have seen this. So how you manage? How do we assist? How do we help our parish priest? How do we help the parochial vicar of our church? How do we help the vicariate in that case? There is a catechetical ministry. Structurally, the functioning, because it's different when you talk about an academic institution, di ba? It's different when you talk about a seminary, when you manage a seminary. It's different when you are in an organization that is a profit organization. The church is a different type of organization, right? So that when we look at it in the context of managing people, so when you say social system, so people interact in the context of what is our mission and vision, what are the things that we want to achieve. The other foundation is obviously behavioral. So human resource management is founded on a behavioral model too, no? That people will behave depending on the situation. People are motivated by certain things, so they behave in such a way that sometimes we didn't expect it, but that's how they're supposed to behave. So in the behavioral aspects, in the recent literature, no? So we're talking of science, of psychology here, industrial psychology, you are referring to moods and emotion. Pag si father may mood, what do we do? No? Parang ganun. But,
yes.
Ah, yes, mga sister ang nagsabi na yun. Sa father sa may S, ano may S?
Subo.
Ah, yes. Subo. Okay. Sa behavioral, no? So moods, emotions. Ang tanong ko nga sa inyo from a practical point of view, ikaw mismo, no? Kasi iba ang ano eh, iba ang context ng simbahan sa kumpanya. Because of certain, you will know that it's different because of the kind of work that we do, right? So it's not a matter, that's why we talk about behavioral aspect. We talk about resource-based view. What is this? Because in managing people, you are also to look at the resources that are available. No? So resource-based, meaning you manage people in the context of the resources that you have. So when you talk of resources, basically, what are these? You talk about, lagi natin problema. Panginoon, bigyan niyo po kami ng maraming grasya. So you talk about monetary, right? Because we need it, no? practically we depend on love offerings, we call it donations, but that's something real, no? Resources, financial. We talk about what? People as our resource. I mean physical resources, that's part, no?
Yes.
That's part of, okay, in the context of the church, but the temporal needs, that's part of the resources. But that should be part of managing people, it should be part of our view. So what else is part of the resource? The capability of the people. Catechetical ministry, what is a common concern? No? Marami bang volunteers? Do we get adequate number, enough number of volunteers who will help in the catechetical work, right? Or if you talk about in terms of, sometimes there are volunteers, but the question is, are they competent? Diba? The other one is, are they committed? Yeah, so that's basically part of when you talk about resource view, no? And the resource based. The other one is stakeholder. What is this? In simple terms, the stakeholders theory simply talks about having different people who are involved, stakeholders, that's how we call them. So who are our stakeholders in the context of the church? So lahat, no? The lay and the ordained, no? Lahat tayo stakeholders in that sense. In an organization, pag sinabi stakeholders, sinasabi mo employee, that's the term. No? But in the church, you call them tayo yung ordained, yan ang sabi, the lay and the ordained, diba? Nasabi natin in the context. Pero lahat ng tao, meaning lahat ng tao, lahat ng mananampalataya, no? The faithful are all the stakeholders as far as the church is concerned. Yun ang difference. That's why I'm trying to differentiate. Because if it's a profit organization, very ang stakeholders mo, parang in the context of business, yung consumer mo, anong equivalent natin? Yung faithful. Yun ang ano, I just want to show you that that is how you how we view it, but they're the same, no? Yung sasabihin mo, for example, na sino yung mga administrator? So, yun nga pa, the parish priest, kung the bishop, ito yung mga, the clergy, no? In that case, administrators of the diocese, in that case. Kasi, pagka organization, who are your administrators? Eh, yun yung mga may-ari, no? The investors, in that case. If it's a conglomerate, and if it's owned, for example, by a particular family, sila yung may-ari in that case. So, those are the stakeholders. Ang maganda rito sa stakeholders, what they're saying, whether you are from within, meaning you are part of the parish, you're from within, yung external mo, yung parishioners, or the faithfuls in that case, they have both should be considered in the process of managing your people. Yun ang sinasabi po rito. Equal importance. Yun ang sinasabi. And then the other one is humanistic. Ito, medyo bago, of course, nandiyan na. Humanistic theory. Kasi 1, 2, 3, 4, yan basically very management, profit-oriented. Ang concern mo lang yung what you need to achieve. Kasi sa simbahan, wala naman tayo pinag-usapang competitive. No, competitive advantage. So, yung mga ano, that you will be preferred over the others. No? But if you really have a context, ako nga, I want to be more practical about it, you can ask me. But now, given the proliferation of other religious sects, no, or denomination, ang tanong ko sa atin eh, as predominant, as a Catholic, are we not, parang ganun, are we not losing our customers? We from a business language, that's what I'm talking about, no? Why are they leaving? Why are they preferring to go to other groups, no? In that case. And from a context then, again, I just want to use my language. What do we need to do so that we're able to maintain? Diba? Yun ang context na. Kaya, what is important is, hindi lang yung in the context, kasi wala naman tayong profit na pinag-usap. We're talking really of what? Spreading the word of God. That is really our vision, mission, that's our goal, no? So, bring the kingdom of God, no? In that case. So, my question is, when you talk of humanistic, kasi po yung apat, from a traditional point of view, walang pansin sa tao na in terms of you talk about just ito na yan, justice, you talk about... Kaya siya, minimalistic with that. Actually, I was the one who added the social doctrine of the church. So I have written an article on the precarious employment ng Catholic, published in our journal. I was talking about that work should really be anchored on the social doctrine of the church on human work. No? If you're familiar with the social teachings, diba pinag-usapan natin? Pinag-usapan, why is there exploitation of labor? Because hindi siya anchored on the social teaching of the church. And in fact, I don't, that's why I'm asking you, how long have you been in your ministry? And if you're familiar with problems of labor, if you look at the Department of Labor, there are many cases filed against church administrators, unfair labor practice. Yung mga ganun. But because each part, no, each part of people management, each part when they feel that they are not treated with respect, it's they feel if you violate what is the teaching of the church, no, as far as work is concerned, respect for work, yung pag-uunyon, lahat yung kasama, no? So these are theoretical foundation. Meaning, when you manage people, it is not simply a way of how you do things, but they are anchored on certain theoretical foundation. My point is, if you are an administrator, which of these theoretical frameworks you want to anchor managing your people? It's for you to decide. Do not ask me what is the best. I'm asking you, this is one of the questions that I want you to reflect. For so many years that you have been managing people, whether it's at the parish level, catechetical, diocesan, vicariate level, my point is, maybe this is something that you can reflect on in your prayers. Not now, maybe in the future. Oh, man, no? I have been managing people. But what is the theoretical foundation that I am using? Am I really conscious about the social doctrine of the church on human work when I manage my people in the parish or in the vicariate? Are they receiving minimum wage? Do they have breaks? Yung mga ganun, because that's part of the social doctrine. Do I allow them to join unions? So that's part. You don't need to answer, but that's what I'm just asking. But this is part of really managing your people in the organization. So that's the theoretical part. The other one that I want you to be aware of when you manage people in the organization is the legal framework. No? So when you manage people, there is a legal framework to it. I think tomorrow your speaker is a lawyer, but he will talk about the financial management aspect, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, and fundraising, that is his topic. But on my end, managing people will have always a legal framework, no? Meaning the UMA, the United Nations human rights instruments, no? Yung mga basic human rights. Then you talk about ILO Convention, freedom of association, no? Freedom to what? Form unions. Collective bargaining, yan ang mga ILO, no? Yung child labor, forced labor, yan yung mga conventions. When you talk about this, these are really agreements that member countries of ILO agree to abide by. And then you talk about, of course, the Philippine Constitution, the Bill of Rights, no? Lahat nandun din yan as basic. And then you talk about the Labor Code of the Philippines, basic as far as employee. Because we are also employer, no? The church is an employer. We employ people, whether on a full-time, part-time basis, seasonal, contractual. But we need to be aware of this because sometimes, you know, that's what I'm saying, yun yung difference sa simbahan. Eh. Yung mga tao nahihiya sa atin kasi kayo, pare at madre. Eh, yung iba kasi yung respeto. That's what I'm saying. There is a different kind of transaction that is happening. So that people are not really able to immediately express the needs that they have as far as legal requirements are concerned. Magtatanong sa iba, tanong mo kay father. Sometimes si father hindi naman din aware. I'm not saying, because it's not really part of the curriculum. No? It's not being taught. You get to know about it once you are there, and then you get to realize, I need to know what is the labor code, I need to know what is the minimum wage, I need to know if I need to pay overtime pay, and all of, because there is a legal framework. When you manage people, Because one of the reasons to make them stay in the work is to provide what is required by law. At least that's the minimum requirement. That's the minimum requirement that you need to provide. Because people will leave and they will go. Kasi no matter what, so if pagtulong sa, pero meron yung manit, right? You need to, because they need to leave too in that case. No? Because remember, the people that you manage are lay people, right? Yung vocation, yung commitment nyo sa as priests and nuns, magkaiba sa lay, di ba? Merong ano yun. And now, you are now the, what? You are now the administrator. So, how are you able to do this? No? Kasi meron siyang ibang needs. May pamilya, no? Meron gano'n that you need to address. Helping her. So, these are the legal framework. I just want you to be aware that as administrators, you need to be familiar with these two. Okay, so that's very important. Am I making sense? So,
yes.
Yeah,
so the third one that I want you to realize when you manage people, when you manage people in the organization is the approach, no? There are two approaches that you can do here, no? The first one is if you use a time frame. I know you have been reading about this. I don't know, parang walang input, but you're talking about strategic, di ba? Meron tayo strategic planning. Yes. Parish level, we do strategic planning. Diocesan level, strategic planning. Meron pang, di ba? Strategic planning. Basically, what is this in simple terms? Time frame, you do a long-term planning. That's strategic. When you talk of strategic, you really look at 5 to 10 years from now, no? So parang ang tanong ko sa inyo, how do you plan? Will you be able to plan at least in the catechetical ministry strategically for people? Yung managing people, ilan yung taong kailangan nyo, what kind of resources, where will you deploy them, what kind of training program. So these are strategic directions, no? Vis-a-vis the mission vision of the church. The other one is operational. What is that time frame-wise? This is the day-to-day. No? Operational is day-to-day. Ang time span niya year, 1 year lang. So when you do planning, basically most of what we do, planning in our parish level diocese, basically operational day. Yung isang taon lang. At most, we plan depending dun sa appointment ni Father, di ba? Depending sa appointment ni Father, o kaya appointment ni Bishop. Ganun ang ano, planning, di ba? It is dependent on who is assigned. And we know, mostly, the way we do it, there is no such thing as something permanent. No? Alam naman natin, the assignments of you can be from, depending on the need, di ba? Kaya minsan, you're not able really to plan most of the time strategically. Yun ang isang, I think, I'm talking about managing people. So I think what we need to improve on is really doing a more strategic way of people management. Parang ganun. Kaya lang, for example, ito rin ang common problem even in vocations. No? Hindi ka naman maka-strategic. Parang ano yun, ang kumpanya kaya yung mag-ano, no? May pera ko. Pero yung vocation kakaiba. Yun ang sinasabi ko. Kaya yung dimension, that's why you ask, I already telling you, yun ang kakaiba. You cannot strategic ka pala and then, okay, I will be able to have 20 vocations, but hindi yun, di ba? Depende sa ano ng Espiritu Santo, di ba? Maraming kakaiba, that's what I'm talking about. So it's not that easy. But on some other things, you can do strategic plans. For example, planning about church. Yung mga temporal aspects, madaling i-ano yun, no? Pero it's really the vocation. Or for example, even nga, tanong ko eh, when you talk of people management and you talk, in business, you talk about key performance indicators, ano yung output. No? Hindi kasi tayo, I think there are certain things that we need to achieve. Lagi kong tanong yan. How do you measure, mamaya yung pag-usapan natin, the performance of an effective catechist? Effective catechetical director, anong measure mo? Mamaya ba kasi? Yeah. Because that's part of people management, measuring performance. So how do you go about it in practical terms, in doing things? in, pinag-uusapan ba yan mamaya? We talk about, how do you measure? Sa dami ba nang nabigyan mo ng catechism? Sa dami bang na-convert mo na Katolik? Yung mga ganun ba, no? I think it's something that should really be reflected on seriously in the context of strategic planning. Yun lang ang sinasabi ko na nandiyan. Because it's an approach in managing people. Or we just go on operational, no? Yung as the need arises, day to day. The other approach that you can look at, ito pa rin yung managing people, we look at it more on a developmental level. Developmental meaning people, learning in the process, kasi meron tayo people learn, people find meaning as they do it, or we do it administratively. Ano yun? Yung batay sa rule, tanggal. Pag hindi ka maroon, tanggal. No? Yan ang administrative. That's why I'm telling you, tanggal. When you're more of the by the book, tanggal yung tao. You don't know? Alis ka dyan. O, kung nagkamali ka, there are certain pwedeng developmental. Then, tawag ko niya pagka nagkala. Ano yan? Pag nag-umpisa ka, yung developmental. Yan ang tinatawag na developmental approach. Laging pinatatawag ng Panginoon. No? Pag niya manage people, lagi, kung nagnanakaw na ilang beses sa koleksyon, lagi bang pag nangumpisa, eh, lagi patawad, gano'n na lang yun. Because these are practical things. Well, they do dishonesty in the, as far as doing their work, right? When they stick on the job, pwede bang lagi patawad? Eh, yun yung ano, yun yung isang difference nga eh. So that is administrative. Or that would you always go into the developmental? Patawad ng patawad until mag-reform. Yung ba yung approach natin? No, I'm just presenting to you because it's a possibility that you can use. Or you can use both. I'm not telling you that there is one best way. I am telling you that these are realities that are happening when you manage people. And it's up to you which one you are using. Of course, there are consequences of doing each of the approach. Making sense so far? Okay. So, ang tanong, ano ba talaga yung human resource management function? So, from the context of human resource, actually, these are the functions. Now, basically, when you talk about, siyempre to organization, ministry, we can use the word ministry here, organization, so generic na yun. Because you need a certain output at the end, no? Yung catechetical ministry. So, what is the performance of the ministry at the end of the year or at by the end of the fifth year? Strategic yung isa, operational lang isa. In terms of managing your people, given the functions that you need to do, familiar pa po tayo dito or I need to explain each one. Briefly? Okay. So, there are basically, kahit anong tignan yung libro, or when you're managing, your work in human resource management will always involve the six. I just want to look at it from a sequential way of doing it. No? So, when you talk about human resource planning, what do you think it will involve? Dito kasi, basically, ito yung tanong ko, ha? Mamaya kasi, meron ako tatanong sa inyo, what is challenging? What are the challenges that you encounter? For example, when you talk about human resource planning, ang una kong tanong is, meron ba kayong job design? Trabaho, baby. Meron ba kayong, yan ang, okay, ile, magkaiba yung job design. Iba yun, ha? Mamaya yung design. Yung job design kasi, will involve, for example, iba yung job design, of course, that is the concretization of a job design. No? The design itself is, ano ba yung nature ng catechetical ministry, since that is our focus, no? What is its main role or function in the church? Siguro alam niyo, dokumento naman yun, no? Based on, ang malinaw yun, di ba? So, given that particular misal, sabihin nyo, what is that? Kasi merong vision, may mission, kasi gagawin mo pa yan. But from the vision, mission, kasi yun din yung broad. But you need to concretize. You need to operationalize
that vision mission into concrete work that you are going to do. So when you say catechize and spread the word of God, what do you mean by that concretely? That's what I'm saying. You need to, that's the design, you need to completely do it. Write it down. Paano po sa inyo, ilan sa inyo ang meron talagang written document on the design? Catechetical na lang, huwag na muna yung parokya. Catechetical kasi topic natin. In something that is documented, something that is written. Written. Oh, yes, ilan yun? See? So, ang first thing when you are managing, you need to document. Yun ang isang people management. Kung teki kayo ngayon, kung teki, syempre nandun sa smartphone, okay? Nasa computer, nasa iCloud, no? Pwede. But you need to document. That is my first question to you. Do you have a work design? Pagka wala, this is the doing, assignment niyan, you need to start documenting. If there are existing, I think you went to Peter and Paul, malapit yun sa Lady of Laban, di ba doon kayo pumunta sa Burgos, Saints, Peter and Paul, no? In that case, di ba na you were able to talk to them? Ang maganda doon, kuha kayo ng dokumento, kasi one way of benchmarking, I think the idea, that's why you went there, is a model community for catechetical work. You need to get the document so you see it's easier rather than really from memory, no? So, yun ang gawin nyo. So, if that are existing, I don't know if this is the first time also that you meet as a class. Siguro isa that you can really do as a class, magawa kayo ng ano, gawa kayo ng isang e-group. Tapos, ano na lang, say, yung mag-meeting, pamasahe, online, no? So, come up with a group, e-group. And then send your documents after, I think you're ending by this way. After that, tapos na. Balik ulit kayo, no? I am suggesting, I don't know if you have an
option.
Oh, yeah. So, mag-sharing kayo doon. Lahat ng document nyo, share kayo doon. Because you can do it in a Google Drive. Tapos, share lang yung document. Mag-create kayo. So that you can access. You are able to look at it. You don't need to start. Kasi copy-paste naman. Ano naman ang gagawin niya? Acknowledge niyo lang sa inyo kinuha yung source. So, let's say, diocese of ganito. Kung lahat yung mga, you will see my handout at the end, they have the references. Ganun din ang gagawin niyo ngayon. Kasi you cannot just start from the beginning. Kung meron namang mga existing na, that's the idea, no? To have models. So, what I'm saying, the design. Once you have you are able to identify ano yung mga gagawin? Kasi yung mga gagawin, marami. So when you say, catechize, so ano ba yung gagawin? Kailangan bang meron? Hindi, yung actual catechetical work, ano ba yan? Meron ba yung mga sessions, learning, may ganito, may ganyan? Oo, marami, no? Yun yung mga lahat ng gagawin. Those are all the activities that you need to do. But the point is, after identifying all, ngayon ang tatanungin mo, who will do it? Iba yun eh. So that what you need to do with all those work, you have to group them according to functions or certain things. Functions can be in terms of commonality, no? So lahat ba eh? Kasi meron mga function na maybe ang role ng function training, lahat puro yung catechetical na teaching. Baka meron namang catechetical na ang trabaho mo, office work. Kayo yung, sa teacher kasi ang tawag ng designer, no? Kayo yung gumagawa. Kung baga sa misa, yung misalet yung gumagawa, no? Di ba? Parang binabasa. Pero yung, di ba, nakakatuwang gumawa yung pasahin mo yung misalet, yung boss ko. Kung di natin sa Manila, yung gagawa nga, puro parit madre, may reflection lagi sa harap, tsaka sa liyo. Mahirap yun ha, buong taon, yung Sunday, meron na gano'n. But that's for someone to manage that one is a lot of work, no? Parang, that's what I'm saying, maraming trabaho, but you have to group them to functions. And then in the catechetical ministry, may function din siyempre, kaya may fundraising, we'll take care of generating funds. Diba? That's a function. Trabaho pa rin yun, kaya nga hindi masasabi job description din, no? But the first thing that you need to know, enumerate lahat ng gagawin dapat ng catechetical ministry. Ganun muna. And then, after that, tsaka nyo i-group. Another way of doing it, structurally, may idea ka na, no? Kung meron na kayong units, siguro what you need to do now is to review kung yun talaga ang dapat gawin vis-a-vis division mission. Kung ano yung, yun nga eh, what do you want to see as your performance at the end, given a time break? 1 year? 3 years? 5 years? Siguro, yun nga, basically, ang pinaka-realistic, if you will ask me, yung ano, yung, what do you call, appointment ni bishop o appointment ni priest administrator, whoever. Kasi normally, di ba, pag nagpalit, nagpapalit din ng, ano, ng direction, no? Yun na yung pinaka-practical. Am I making sense? Okay.
Yes.
Ngayon, ang tanong, sige, okay, lahat ng trabaho nandiyan, ang dami, ang dami na generate. So, what will you do now, no, na hatin? So, that's what you call, meron tao kasi sa planning, may tinatawag na pagkatapos ng vision, you talk about now, okay, you now organize, meaning you divide the work, dividing the work. So, when you're able to divide the work, you will need to come up with a JD. Ito na yung nalang job description. Yun yung tinatawag na. Uy, wala pa yun. So, job. Okay, so you need to have a job description. May tanong po ako. Ilan po sa inyo ang may job description ng lahat ng mga taong involved sa catechetical ministry? Lahat siya may job description. How many JDs do you have? Ito yan, JD. Yan ang shortcut yan, JD. Job description. Okay. Ngayon ang tanong, maybe managing your people, you need to improve your job description. Ano ba basically ang laman ng isang job description?
Function.
Ano pa?
Norms.
The limit.
The limit. Okay. Ano pa yun? So, if you are to write, ano ang unang-una? You need to have first the job title. Siyempre, job title muna. Now, that's why you improve your
job title.
That's very important. Siyempre muna, unang-una job title. Kunwari, parish priest o parish priest. Parish priest. Kunwari, yun ang job title. O kaya, mother superiora. Kunwari, mother province. But you need to have the job title. So, di ba, catechetical?
Director.
Okay. Kasi yun ang function. Pwede kang parish priest. But that's another job description. You're not supposed to put together. Kasi pwede kang parish priest, tapos nung nag-meeting, dahil ikaw yung pinakamadanda, ikaw ngayon ang inapoy na katikin. Magpapang job description mo. Ay, ikaw pinakamadanda, marami kasi nasabi, ikaw ang i-assign. Di ba gano'n ang ano, pagka nagsalita ka, kaya huwag ka magsasalita. Okay ba sa inyo na habang ina-entertain ko kayo mga kayo? I won't mind that they eat while I talk. I'm used to it. Okay. How about you? For the love of God. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Okay, dapat. Sige. If you have two different jobs, hindi nyo pwedeng pagsamahin sa isang JD. Ang isang klase ng trabaho, isang job title, isang job description. Maliwanag po, yun ang tama. Isang main group ng mga work that are related is the job description. Kasi po, pinagawa natin simbahan, halo-halo, tapos ang bayan, isa lang. Kaya na, unfair. Kaya na, isa na, wala pang bayan. Abunado pa, kami na nga nagbibigay pa. Tayo-tayo lang naman nag-uusap. Ano na malalang. Secret. Okay, job
Tapos ang job title. Dapat yung job title, ito pa rin yun. The job title should be descriptive of the functions that you will see here. No? So pag sinabi mong, for example, pag sinabi mong kategetical director, o kaya coordinator, yung pala wala namang kino-coordinate. Hindi pwede yun. Yung pala messenger at trabaho. So it should be reflective. Okay. Tapos, mayroon lang siya tawag dito. Ang tawag sa kanya ay location in the organization. What is that? Sige nga, tingnan ko kung ang JD niyo meron. Location in the organization. What is the meaning of location in the organization? So, okay. Actually, location is the office. Where the particular position is attached to. Okay. So, for example, catechetical, tapos, office of the catechetical ministry. Kung may, may office, pwede rin kasi ang location rather than director is diocese, no? Pwede kasi ganun. Kasi sabi ko lang, it has to have a location. Oo, dapat meron siyang office. Hindi ka pwedeng on your own, no? Because the next one, after the location, who is your immediate
superior?
Okay, ang tawag niya immediate superior.